All right, thank you everyone for returning back to my channel to watch a video. As you saw, the products at the beginning were the ones that I used for this hairstyle. I did a lot of editing to cut out the fact that I cannot part. This took way longer than you see on the screen, believe me when I tell you. So anyway, as you can see, I part the bottom, leave the rest up at the top using a rubber band because I can never find my clips. Maybe I'm not the only one that can never find my clips. But anyway, so now that I have this bottom half separated, and I know my part is a little off. If you follow me on Instagram, you know that I have a bald spot that I am constantly trying to cover up right about in that area where I am right now. So that part's always going to be a little off. Odd until that completely covers up, but I do have some updated pictures on my Instagram page. It has grown back pretty nicely. So anyway, now that I had separated that, I'm now separating it into two. Found some clips, yay. Two sections instead of doing the one twist, the one flat twist all the way around the back, I decided that I would do two flat twists around the back. And I just clip this up so that it can stay out of the way while I am doing this part. This is my Garnier Fructis. Love, love, love this conditioner. I put this on all the time. Wash and goes, twist outs, flat twist. Very moisturizing. So I just put this throughout. The piece of hair just does not want to cooperate. So anyway, my next step, I will be putting in this clear clear coconut edge control. I'll put all the products in the description box below so that you all can see everything I use. I find that when I use this edge control, it just really makes my flat twist look better, stay shinier, and gives it kind of like a, I don't know, slick down but not gel look. It's hard to explain. So I put it on the top and the bottom before I twist my hair all the way around, just so that I can have a hold all the way throughout the twist that I'm going all the way around with. Oops, some hair came out. Now I'm just brushing it so that it can blend in. Sometimes when you put the edge control on your hair, if you don't brush it, you'll find clumps of it everywhere. That one piece of hair just does not want to stay out of my way. So anyway, it's time to twist now. I'll try to bring the camera a little closer so you can see, but I missed it by a few. Can't really see. So yeah, I tried, y'all. But I do have a flat twisting video, a little short one on my channel. So anyway, I take this all the way around. I end up switching my hands in the back so that I can continue to go around. And it's just a basic flat twist all the way around. I lost my little way right there where you see me stop at, but got it back. So we're just gonna go all the way around to the other side. I had a lot of people, when I posted this picture on my Instagram page, say, what does the back look like? And I don't think I ever did take a picture of the back. So this video will show you exactly how I achieved the back and what it ended up looking like when I finished. Because I get a lot of questions about what in the world does the back look like if your sides look that way, what did you do with all the hair? So anyway, let's twist it all the way around. Not perfect, but it's there. So now I'm gonna get ready to start on the second one. So we'll just take that down. I did the same concept. I just cut it. I don't think you all want to see me put the gel, I mean the edge control and everything on. So I did the same thing, edge controlled top and bottom for the twist, brushed it in, and then I just continue to twist around the back. For some reason, I didn't really have to switch my hands up on this twist, per se. But get all the way to that side. Here we go. I'm going to end up with two twists here, just hanging. And I did something pretty simple, y'all. I just combined the two together. Checking out the back a little bit. I'm just going to combine the two together to do a little bantu knot. Nothing dramatic. Just a bantu knot on the side. Not too tight as to not pull my hair. That's it. Then I'm going to start on the top of my head. And the way that I do it, that bantu knot will not be seen. It'll be completely covered up. I went really fast to show y'all the rods that I used, but I will put a picture of those in the, not a picture, I'm sorry, a description of those in the description box below. This water bottle only has Jamaican black castor oil and water in it. That's it. Nothing special. So just brush it to smooth it out. Okay, of course, this is my Mielle Organic mint oil. Love it. I always put that on my hair, so I added that in for moisture and shine. I'm also putting on the Garnier Fructis that I showed you earlier in the video for my conditioner, and one of my new faves, the Egyptian Collection 24 karat gold by Main Choice. I love it. It's just, I don't know, it smells good, it keeps my curls good. I love it for wash and goes and twist outs. It's just awesome. So anyway, this smoothed it all the way to the end. Now I always roll a couple of times on the end. Probably didn't see it because this video is sped up some, but I do roll my ends a few times. And I kind of, I guess you could say, twist the roller to give it a spiral look. So I just repeat on every one of them. Oops. And you saw it there a little bit where I took it on the end and rolled it a few times. Spiral it till I get close to my head, and then I just roll it the regular way. But that's what gives it the spiral effect that you see, that you'll see at the end of the video once I take them down. I just like that look, kind of gives it a springy look. So basically that's all I'm doing to each one. In the end, I'm gonna have several, like 20. Yeah, here she comes. She's silly and does this when I'm recording all the time. Oh my God. Okay. She left. Okay, this took me about 30 minutes. So this is the next morning. Now y'all, I was so happy when I was taking them out. Might not look that happy, but I really was. I was excited, like, oh, they're turning out just like I wanted them to turn out. Very, very excited. Then I start to get to the ones that did not turn out like I wanted them. Ugh. It's always got to be one or two curls. Always. Never fails. These are awesome. These are not. Ugh. I hated those curls. So anyway, I had to go to work. So what I decided to do was to take all the ones down that were done right. Then to comb out, brush out the ones that were like, I don't even know what made them do that. I think I might have put a little bit too much hair in them. I actually added some more of the 24 karat on it.
brushed it, smoothed it out, and we re-rolled. I didn't add any more water, any more moisture, just the 24 karat gold gel back in. Re-rolled them, and I went to work. Now this is me at work. These are the ones that I left in. I probably left them in another 4 hours, and as you can see, they did great. Like, I was so excited, because I was sad about those 4 or 5 that decided to do their own thing. So I was very, very excited that what I did worked. Sometimes you just have to try again. So they worked, and they were very springy, as I can call them, very hydrated, just did exactly what I wanted them to do. So no worries, I am at work at my desk, but I am actually on lunch. So now I'm going to pull them apart. Unlike some people, I like a little frizz. A little frizz to me, I don't know, I just like a little frizz. It doesn't have to be uniformed completely all the time, so a little frizz doesn't really bother me. So anyway, I can't tell you how much I pick them out. It just depends on your desired look. I will pick them out. I didn't pick them, sorry. Pull them apart. Depends on what you're looking for. Some people might only pull a few of them apart. Others might pull till you get a big fro. I don't know. It just depends on what you're looking for. Now, as you can see, you can't see that bantu knot that I did because I rolled the hair to go towards that way, so that once I do all the picking and pulling out, it is completely covered up. So you really don't see where the flat twist ends at. So I basically have one side going. Have it going to one side so that it'll cover up the bantu knot area. So I just continued to pick and pick and pick it apart until I got the look that I was looking for. I really liked this hairstyle. It's one that I've done several times, different products and different ways. So, but this I really liked. And that's that night once I got home, but as you see, you cannot see the bantu knot at all. Loved it. So thank you for watching. Please rate, subscribe, comment. Thank you all. Bye.